Good morning everyone. In the last class we are trying to discuss trim up related example here. So what is the advantage we are going to get whenever we are trying to work with this particular trim up here? So basically the advantage here we are going to get in a by default the ascending order we are going to get. So whenever we are trying to insert the data into this particular tree map, so what it's doing internally, by default if you are not implementing the particular comparator, by default is going to use the comparable interface, and using the comparable interface the compareTo method is going to call. And here what we are doing internally, we are trying to check with the object here. So if the object is greater than to another object here, so what is happening internally, so which is trying to return the int value here. So that is we already identified in the last class. So if it is not greater than, so we are going to get minus value, something called negative values we are going to get, and so that we can identify, so which is a less than to the particular given object here. Right now, so we'll try to implement one more implementation class here, because we'll try to check with the simple example on related to this. Later we'll move on to the one important concept, something called, this is the another implementation class, linked hash map here. So we are going to discuss the linked hash map, how exactly this particular linked hash map will work internally. If you observe here, you can see, so how exactly that the data is ascending. Basically the data is ascending on a alphabetical order. So first we are going to get as a boolean, later we are getting as a character, later we are getting as a string. But if observe the same order, we did not insert the data. So now you can observe, first we insert the boolean, later we insert the string here, later we insert the character here. But even though if we are using with a different format here, the order with a different here, so we are getting some ascending order. So because of what we identified in the yesterday class, we use the important to the method called compareTo, which is coming from the comparable interface, right? So using the particular method, we identify how exactly the data is inserting, and later we identify the particular get method, how it is working. So basically first what it's doing here, we try to generate the hash code of this particular key. Later what is doing here, internally it's going to check with the particular appropriate node. So along with hash code and key, based on this particular two condition, what is doing internally, it will try to find out the particular index where exactly this particular object is stored here, cutting the point. And same way we identified this particular remove method. So whenever we are trying to work with this particular remove, which is taking as a two parameters here, so first one key and second one value, first one key and second one value. So what is happening internally, whenever we are trying to specify key and value, so both should be matched here. If this particular value is not available, what happening, this particular object is not removed from the particular tree map here, right? So instead of using this particular two parameterized remove method, what we can do, we are having one more method. What is another method? Something called map.remove. So the map.remove, which is going to take as a only string, so it's not taking any another parameter called values here. So you can observe here, so this is I'm trying to explain here, the remove method, which is expecting as only object key. So whenever you are trying to specify the particular key, what happens here, if the key is identified, it will try to remove the particular object here. So this is the alternative, right? And along with this, we identify key set here. So this particular key set is implemented to get the set of keys here. That we have implemented in the yesterday class, and we are trying to load the particular key one by one. So later we are working on the values method. So these are the basic methods are implemented in the particular map interface. in the particular map interface here. Getting the point? So along with this, what we can do? So we are having another options call, because the tree map which is implementing from the navigable interface, navigable map interface here. So whenever the navigable map interface here, what happens here? So we can access these many methods here. We can access these many methods here. So to understand here how exactly so this particular methods are working here. So first we'll check with the lower entry, and so we need to specify the key here. So to understand how exactly this particular lower entry is working here, let me comment. So this particular two methods here. Okay. So now here I want to check here lower entry dot map dot lower entry. So now we can observe. So which is expecting the particular key. So what key we can specify here? Now I want to specify this particular boolean here. So I'm going to specify here how exactly internally it is working here. How exactly internally it is working here. If I'm going to run the same example in a debug mode, you can observe. So let me change the perspective of this particular Eclipse. Now we are in the debug perspective. Okay, now you can observe here. We are trying to put to three methods. Later we are trying to load an object. Now we are into the particular method call lower entry. So you can observe here what is doing here, which is trying to return entry object here. So which is trying to return entry object here. So based on the key value pair. So what is the key we are taking here? Something called string. So whatever the value here, something called double. Okay. Now we will observe how exactly it's going to work this particular lower entry. If I'm trying to enter into this particular lower entry, we need to check here. We need to check lower entry we are calling. Internally, we are having one more method, something called get lower entry. We need to move inside this particular get lower entry method. So now you can observe we are into the get lower entry. Okay, what is the root we are having here? The root we are having character here. So the particular root we are having character. Cutting the pun. So now we'll check with here. So the p not equals to null. What we are doing here, we are calling the compare here. So what is the key we are having? Something called boolean. And inside this particular key, what we are going to get? Character we are going to get. So character we are getting here, because the root is getting as a character object here. Character inside key, so which is returning as a character. The value we are getting as a 879, because we are working on the key value pair. Okay, we identify using this particular compare method. So if we want to understand internally, as I explained here, we are not using the comparator, so which will return null here. So if this particular null, what happens internally? So which is going to call this particular compare to method, which is going to call this particular compare to method, and it will try to return the integer value. Getting the point? Integer value. So we'll observe how exactly this particular integer value is going to return here. Now if I'm going to move, so now we'll try to check with the next line. Observe here, what is the value we are getting? Something called, so whatever the value we specify, the value we are getting as a less than, because so which is a negative value, we are getting as a less than value. So negative value, it's become less than value which is going to return here. If you are getting positive numbers, we can identify, so those are into the greater than values. Okay, so what, so this particular key, whatever the key we specify, and so this particular key is a less than here, because the b is a like greater value compared to the particular character. Boolean is a greater value compared to this particular character. Now we are having the condition here, this particular CMP greater than 0, we are moving into this particular section. But two, this condition is not satisfying, we are moving into else. Because, so the value we are getting as a less than here. Minus 1 is nothing but less than. Okay, now, so we need to check here. So what is the P dot left we are going to have? The P dot left, what is we are going to have here? Something called Boolean. Getting the point. So P dot left, we are going to have object called Boolean. So now, so not equals to null, we are trying to return the P dot. So here, we are trying to return here P value. So what is the P value we are getting? Boolean here. Previously, we are having character information. Now, so we are moving into this particular okay, so directly we are coming out of this particular while block here. So simple understand we need to know here, if the P is not equals to null, what happens here? It will try to iterate multiple times. This loop is going to iterate multiple times here because we are in the while loop here. Okay, now we identify the CMP we are getting as a minus 1. The CMP we are getting as a minus 1 here. So this condition is not satisfied. So directly we are coming back to the else block here. Inside this particular else block, this condition is satisfied because we are getting the P dot left not equals to null. The P dot left to not equals to null, we are assigning into this particular P. So if you observe, this loop is going to repeat one more time. So if I'm going to observe one more time, this loop is repeating here. Now we can check with the CMP. So now we can identify 0. So 0 also, this condition will not satisfy. We'll go for the else block. Let's go for the else block. Basically, why we are getting 0? And if you observe, what is the key we are having? Boolean. And P dot key also, we are going to have Boolean. We are going to have Boolean. So both the keys are matching here. Getting the point. So both the keys are matching. Whenever the keys are matching here, this particular compare method, we are going to get 0 value. Getting the point. 0 value is nothing but the both the conditions are going to satisfy, it will return 0. So if it is greater than, what we are going to have? We are going to have the positive values. So if it is a less than, we are going to have negative values. So this way, we need to understand the particular compare to method. Right, now we can check here P dot left. So we need to understand the P dot left is not equals to null. This condition will become false here because the left we are getting as a null. So directly we are moving into this particular else section. Now we can observe what is the P dot parent here. The P dot parent we are going to have here the character here. The P dot parent we are going to have as a character here. Right, now we identify the character information. So now we need to check your P. So what exactly the P? We are having the Boolean here. So the parent we are having character. So don't confuse here. Basically, this is the parent of this particular Boolean. And here we are having, this is the child here. So how many records we are having here? Two. One is the parent and one is a child here. Okay. Now you can observe parent not equals to null and child is equals to parent dot left. So as of now, this condition will satisfy. So as of now, this condition will satisfy. If you observe here, which is returning as a true. The while block, which is returning as a true. So later, what happening internally? So it's trying to change the values here. So whatever the parent object we are having, so which is assigning into this particular child. So initially, the child we are having Boolean. So the Boolean is going to override with the character here. So now you can observe. So both are characters. So even you can identify parent also will have character. But here, the parent dot parent here. The parent dot parent. What we are going to have here, something called null. So careful observe here. Initially, from the P dot parent, we are trying to load the object here. The entry object we load here, something called character. And the character is going to override with null here. So now you can observe the parent we are getting as a null, this particular loop is going to stop because the parent we are getting as a null here. So whenever the parent we are getting as a null, what happening internally? So the parent will become null here. The parent will become null. So we are trying to return this particular parent here. So now what you are understanding here? So now what you are understanding here? So basically export entity we need to check here. So if it is a this particular E is null, so simply they are trying to return null. Now we can identify the entry, the E value we are getting as a null. Okay. So understand this particular method. To understand this particular lower entity, so first what we need to do? We need to go to the navigable map. So we need to go to the navigable map. So what exactly particular navigable map contains here? So now we can see lower entity. So we are working on the this particular method. Now try to return this particular information. So it will try to return the key value mapping, so that we identify which is trying to return the one entry object here, right? So which is associated to this particular key here. So the key, if you understand here, so whatever the greatest value we are having here, getting the point? So which is having the condition here, greatest value. So then only the particular greatest value which is going to return. So for the boolean, we don't have any greatest value because boolean is the first element. Boolean is the first element, getting the point? So because of this, we did not find out the particular greatest value. Right. So strictly less than the particular given value, what happens internally? It will return null here. It will return null here. So this is very important condition we need to understand here. Okay, observe here what we are doing here. So which is checking with the one condition here. Okay, now we'll move with the one more object. Getting the point? I want to click on F8 here. So instead of boolean, what I can do? Something called string. The same example I want to run here. So I will try to explain one two methods. So the remaining method, try to work on the same in a debug manner. So you are going to have more information here. Observe here, we are inserting the data and later we are loading an object. Now again I'm calling this particular lower entity. So we are moving into inside this particular get lower entity. So now you can observe here. So what is the root we are going to get here? The root we are getting as a character here. The root we are getting as a character. So p not equals to null. Later what we are going to do, we are calling this particular compare method. So based on the key, what is the key we are having? So one is a string and another one p dot key is nothing but character. So it will try to compare this particular two keys here. So based on this particular compare, what happens internally? So we are going to get one integer value. So now we can identify 16. So now what you are understanding here, whatever the key we are specifying here, so which is the greater value compared to this particular p dot key. Okay, now you can see the condition will going to satisfy. So p dot write, so what we are going to have in the p dot write string, the p dot write we are having string, the p dot left we identified here, so something called boolean. Getting the point? So this is very important here. So p dot left we are having the boolean data, and p dot right we are having the particular string data. Now again they are trying to assign the p dot right here. The loop is going to repeat one more time because p we are getting not equals to null. Now you can observe both the keys are same. So how we are identified? The key we specified as a string. And here the p dot key we are calling as a string. both the keys are having same year. So this particular compare method will return 0. So now we can observe which is returning 0. So again, we need to go back to the else section, p dot left. This particular p dot left, not so basically the p dot left will have null here. So the p dot left, we are having null here. Okay, the if condition will not satisfy, moving into else here. So what exactly this particular p dot parent will contain? So something called character. The p dot parent, we are going to have character, and later, so p dot, and whatever we are having the current object, we are passing as a child, something called string. So now you can observe in the parent and the child, in the parent we are having the character object here, and in the child we are having, in the child we are having string. So these are coming from the where. So this is very important here. These are the three objects only we are working here. So these are the three objects only we are working here. Don't confuse here. So these are not coming from the somewhere. So these are the object we passed from the our main class called tree map demo. Okay, back to here. So we need to check here parent dot left. So what is the parent we are having? Character. So now this condition will go into satisfy first time. Sorry, p dot left, not we are not getting an object. Okay, so basically, so ch, the left we are having boolean here. So that is the reason it's not satisfied. Basically the ch we are having as a string object, and the parent dot left we are getting as a boolean. We are getting as a boolean. So because of this, the conditions are not satisfying here. What happens internally? It will try to return the parent here. It will try to return the parent here. So what parent we are going to get here? The parent we are getting as a character. So now what you are understanding here? So now you can observe here. So what exactly it's doing here? Basically it's trying to create a abstract map here, and it's going to call the so simple immutable entity, right? Based on this particular E again, which is going to return the same, which is going to return the same object here. Okay, and if I'm trying to run also, we are not finding it. So let me provide this particular return type here. So we are getting as a map dot, sorry, entry one object we are getting here. So to work on this particular entry, what we can do, so simply we can print the key and value. So to print the key and value, what we can do, we are having the method called get key and get value. So basically now what you understand here, so whenever we are trying to specify this particular given key, what is happening internally? It's going to check with the greater than condition, cutting the point. So basically previously we are having the boolean key, because boolean is the first variable, right? In the alphabetical order, boolean is the first variable. So this particular boolean does not have any so greater value. So because of this, in the last example we did not find out the object here. But if you observe, whenever we are trying to pass the particular string here, so it's having some of the greater values. It is having some of the greater value. So which object is trying to return here? The character related object is trying to return. If you observe, if I'm going to run the same example, so now you can observe here. So what is it printing here? The get key is trying to print the character here, and you can observe the line number 22, it will trying to print the get value. It is trying to print this particular get value. Getting the point? So this is the way we need to understand. So somewhere here I'm going to change with the boolean. I'm trying to change this particular boolean. Same example I'm trying to run here. So now we can check here the lower here. We are getting as a null. why we are getting as a null here. So this is the first element where we did not have any greater elements here. Getting the point, this is the first element. How we are identifying whether it is the first one? In the ascending order, so we are trying to insert the data. So in the ascending order, Boolean is the first key. Right. So I'm going to run, we are going to get an exception here. So we are getting an exception here. So what is exception? Null pointer exception, because the lower entity we are getting as a null here. So this we need to understand carefully. So this is we need to understand regarding this particular lower entity. Any questions regarding this particular lower entity? Any questions we are having here? Okay, so if we don't have anything, we'll try to move one more example here. We'll try to check with one more implementation example here. So the remaining method, so try to practice using the same manner, try to work on the in the debug mode, execute the code. So let me know if you're having any queries here. Okay, and now I'm moving into one more important concept here. Another implementation class here, something called linked hash map. So linked hash map here. So using this particular linked hash map, how we are going to work here? Basically, so we identify linked list here. So linked list and linked set. Now we are working on the linked hash map here. Getting the point. So one, now what you understand here, so whenever we are trying to work on this particular linked mechanism, what happens internally? It's going to work on the insertion order here. So how we are going to insert the data? The same way we can get the particular objects here. The same way we can get the particular object here. Now we'll observe here what exactly the constructor will have inside this particular linked hash map. So we need to import from the util package here. Again, I want to check with a string here and double map is equals to new linked hash map. So how many constructors we are having here? So first one is a default constructor, second one is a initial capacity constructor, and third one which is expecting as a collection as a one parameter, and later we can check with float ratio, and the final one we can check with access order. So these are the constructors we are having here. Getting the point. So we'll try to check with because we already familiar with capacity and float ratio, all we identified in the previous example here. So we try to check with the default constructor and what exactly the capacity and fill ratio we can identify here. Okay, now let me work on this particular default constructor here. So when we are going to work on this particular default constructor, so let me open here. So now we can observe basically the linked hash map is calling internally super here. So whenever it is calling super, what we can do, we can check with what exactly it contains here, what is it trying to extend here. Basically this particular linked hash map is going to extend from the which object here. So now we can observe here which is trying to extend from the hash map here. Cutting the point. So which is trying to extend from the hash map. Now you can observe we are having one record call. Now you can observe linked hash map which is extend from the hash map. So that is we already identified a hash map. It contains the the sextant capacity, and we are having ratio 0.75. So this is the default ratio. Same way, where it is applicable to the object called linked hash map. But only the difference here. So what happens internally? Cutting the point. What happens internally? So which will. So basically, internally this particular linked hash map, which is going to work on the node concept here. So which is going to work on the node concept here. So now we understand here whenever we are trying to call push method. What happened here? Linked hash map. Okay. So we'll observe basically the put method is not implemented inside this particular linked hash map. So which is going to call from the which object here? Basically, again, the linked hash map internally, it's going to work on the hash map. Right. Now we need to check with what exactly. So these are the information we are going to have here. And internally, they are creating the one entry. So which is extending from the node here. The node also we identified in the particular hash map node. So using this particular static class, they are creating one entry. So here we are having the before and after here. Before and after here. So later, so which this is the constructor here. So this is the constructor. So what is exactly this particular constructor contain? Hash, key, value, node. Because we identified here. So this we already identified here. In the previous example, when we are discussing the hash map, this particular section we identified. Now you can observe internally they are calling super here. So whenever they are calling the super, so this particular node is going to execute here. So in the node section, so only the four parameter we already identified here, the particular node here. So the node having four properties. The particular node having four properties here. Okay. Now we'll observe the remaining information here. And linked hash from head and tail here. What it contains here. These are the private methods. So first we need to check with public method. So from the public method only we can identify linked hash map. So this is the constructor. This is also one constructor. Now you can observe. So which is expecting initial capacity and float ratio. So which is expecting only initial capacity. And this is the default capacity. So this is the default constructor. Now we can identify the default values here. Now we can identify the default section here. So now this is the another constructor which is expecting the collection information. And this is the one more constructor here. Only the difference here. Access order. Carrying the point. So we need to check with this particular access order here. So we'll observe whenever we're trying to check with the particular access order. Only the methods are implemented contains value. So we identified when we are discussing the particular collection. So contains key, contains object. Same way it's going to work on the contains value. So only the difference here, we are going to work with the head and e dot after here. The head contains all the nodes information. Cutting the point. And based on that, we are going to have after. So after is nothing but, so before and after. So how exactly it's going to create it internally? The same we identified in the previous example here. So it's going to create a one node. It's going to create a one node, something called hash, key, and value, and next here. Same way, it's going to create, one more node here. It's going to create a one more node internally. So with the four parameters. So it's having the relation like this here. We are going to have before node and after node. So it's going to check this particular e dot after is nothing but after the we are having any node. So those are going to loaded here. Getting the point. So those are going to loaded. Right. So now we having four parameters. These four parameters are important. So first one is a hash, key, value, and next node. These are the four parameters. Okay. Now back to here. We identified based on this particular head, if you are having any before or after. So based on that, what is happening here? It will trying to load the value. And simply they are checking the value not equals null. And we are having equals method internally. So internally we are having the equals method. If the whatever the value we are giving, the particular value is satisfied with this particular V, it's returning true. Otherwise, it's returning false. So it is a simple one, the contains value, how it is working internally. Same way, the get method. To work with this particular get method, now we can observe. So firstly, what they are doing internally, they're trying to generate the hash code. After generating this particular hash code internally, it's calling the get node with a hash and a key. With the hash and a key. So imagine we are trying to pass with a boolean. We are trying to pass with a boolean here. Now you can observe we are trying to define the nodes here. Again, we are working on the node array. So if you observe carefully, now we are moving into where here. So now we can see, even though we are calling from the get method, so which is calling the hash map here. So hash map get node. So we already identified here hash map get node here. Getting the point. So every time the node is going to created here, the node based on this particular hash, it's going to store internally in the particular node array. In the particular node array, getting the point. So we already discussed in the previous example this particular get node concept here. Getting the point. In the hash map related example, we already discussed here. So basically, most of the concepts they are going to copy from the hash map here. Only the difference here, whenever we are trying to work with this particular linked hash map, so how we are trying to insert the data, the same way we are going to get. If I want to call this particular map here, so we'll observe here how the data will be inserted here. Getting the point. So simply, if I'm going to call map here, if I'm going to call map, what exactly it will contain internally? So now you can observe. So here you can check here. So how we are inserting the data? The same way we are going to get here. Getting the point. So how we are trying to insert the data? The same way we are getting here. Initially, we inserted the first record called boolean, and later we are trying to check with the string, and later we are trying to check with the character. The same order we are trying to get. Basically, so how we are getting? Based on the particular node concept here. Basically, based on the particular node concept we are trying to get here. Okay. So we'll observe how exactly this particular poke method will work in internally. So if you observe the first put method I want to explain so that you are going to have an understanding of this particular internal style of this particular linked hash map. So this is very important concept we are discussing here. So internal, the flow of execution, if you understand, so it is used to understand any application here. Right. So now I'm trying to move inside this particular put method. Okay, so basically the double is calling here. Okay, now back to your put method. Now we can observe here hash map here. So directly where we are moving here, internally hash map only. Getting the point. So we don't want to discuss more because we already identified in the previous example only. If I'm going to call, so again, the same example, it's calling hash map. Okay, if I'm going to move inside this particular hash, so we'll observe based on this particular hash code, we are going to get this particular hash code of this particular given key. So minus value we are getting here. Right. Now we'll move inside this particular put val method. If you observe this particular put val here, so we need to check with the tab. The table, only one record is inserted. That is called the Boolean data. So just now we inserted one record, something called Boolean. Based on this particular hash code here, so which is inserted into the 2L index location, which is inserted into the 2L index location here. Okay. Now we identify the tab is not equals to null, and this particular length also not equals to null. Getting the point. It's going to check with one more condition here. Okay. What is the hash we are having? Something called some -1880 some hash code we are getting, right? And later what we are doing here? So here n-1. So what is the n we are having? 16. Right. So 16 is nothing but 15 we are going to get. The I value we are trying to get as a 15 here. Based on this particular hash here, what happens internally? We are going to insert the data in the particular tab. So now this particular tab will become null here. The tab will become null because in the 15th location we don't have any data here. Getting the point? In the 15th location we don't have any data here. Right. Now so what we are going to do, we are trying to create a new node with this particular four values here. So first one is a hash key and a value. There is a next node reference here we are making as a null here. Right. So now new node will create here, and the same node which is going to inserted into the location here. What is the I value we are having? You can identify 11. So you can identify 11. So if I'm going to check with the particular table, now we can observe the 11. So 11 is inserted the second record string information. Later what we are doing here, so simply we are increasing the mod count, size also we are increasing, so returning null. So we are trying to return the null here. Getting the point? So this is the way the data is inserting into this particular hash map. But only the difference here, whenever we are trying to work with this particular linked hash map, so how we are trying to insert the data, the same way we are going to get the data here. So this is all about this particular linked hash map here. So try to execute all the methods which we are identified inside this particular hash map interface here, which we identified in the particular map interface here. The simple example we want to check with one more comparator. So this is very important here. Basically the tree set kind of tree map here, which is using internally comparator. So internally it is using the comparator to make the object in an ascending order or some based on some sorting nature. Getting the point? Now we want to understand this particular comparator. The comparator will have two methods. First one is a compare method. Later another one which is going to use equals method. Now you can observe this is a comparator. So we'll try to check with the comparator. First one we identified compare method, and second one so we identify equals method. So these are the default method. So these are the default methods. So if you want to work with a reverse order, what we can do, we can call this particular reverse method, so that we are going to get as a reverse here. Right. Getting the point? So we can get the reverse here. And so here one more here, some comparing here, another comparing here. So we can work with this particular then comparing method. They're having all the we're having. So default method, first we'll check with the compare method how exactly it's going to work. So to work on this particular compare method, so first what we need to do, We need to create a one class here. So what is the name of the class we need to create? Okay, observe here we are having the class called mycomp, so it's nothing but my comparator I'm trying to create, so which is going to implement from the comparator, which is going to implement from the comparator, right? We need to work on this particular comparator. Here we need to specify the T. The type is important here, so we are going to work on the string here. And whenever we are trying to implement here, so which is asking to override the unimplement method, so which we are having the compare method, we need to override here. Okay, we identified here, so which is expecting here string parameters here. Now what I am going to do, so basically, so instead of returning zero, by default the int value we are getting as a zero, but now I want to check with the compare method. So compare to auto, so you can observe here, now you can override the this particular. So instead of working on the default nature, what I am doing here, I'm trying to work with the custom comparator, something called my comparator, right? Only, so this is the way we can call this particular compare method. Only we can call this particular compare method internally. So the string related compare to method we are going to call. So based on this particular string key, what happens here internally is going to check the hash code, getting the point. Internally is going to check with the hash code and it will try to return the key here. Okay, to understand here what we can do, so again we can go for the tree map demo, and here so what I will do, I will try to work on the I'm trying to pass the new mycomp, so it's nothing but so my comparator we created here. So when this particular compare method is going to call, we'll identify here. And if you observe here, to work on this particular custom comparator, so we are trying to pass the comparator as a parameter. The comparator as a parameter. So this is very important here. So whenever we are trying to work with the particular comparator, so what we are doing here, we are trying to pass as the parameter of this particular comparator. Now observe, if I'm trying to run the same example here, so now you can observe whenever we are trying to call the put method internally, it is calling this particular compare to. So now you can observe again it is calling here compare to. So what is our one object here, string, and what is another object here, we are having boolean. So now, so what we are doing here, we are trying to check with the comparing, getting the point. So where it is comparing here, now you can observe whenever we are calling this particular compare. So now you can observe here, basically, so we are inside this particular put method, we are passing key and value. We already identified here the root here, right? So root is not equals to null, so basically this condition is returning false. So directly entering into this particular comparator. Now we are having this particular comparator. Now we are having the object here. So whenever we are trying to specify the comparator as a parameter of the particular constructor of the tree map here, what happens internally? We are going to get an object of this particular comparator. So this is very important here. So otherwise, this comparator, it will try to return the null. Whenever we are specifying the comparator information, then only so this particular object will available here. So because of this, we are getting as a CPR not equals to null, and whatever the T we are getting here, the T we are making as a parent here. And later, what we are doing here, T dot key is nothing about boolean, and whatever the key we passed as a our put method. So those we are checking as a compare here. So now we need to understand here the CMP. How much we are going to get the particular CMP? Okay. So observe. Now we are into this particular tree map here. Now we can identify what is the CMP. Something called 17 here. So 17 is condition satisfied. So what is the T we are having here? Null. The T we are having null here. So basically the while loop we are having the condition t not equals to null. So this condition will return false. The loop is going to terminate. It will back to the end condition. So the parent here. What is the parent we are having? Boolean value and key. This is the way we are trying to make some ascending or descending nature here using our own comparator here. So this is also very important here. Cutting the point. So this is also very important here. Right. Now back to here, we are trying to work on the remaining other operations here. Getting the point. So this is very important here. Now this is the way all the objects are comparing and it's storing internally. So based on this particular lower entry, we are getting a null, because based on this particular boolean, we don't have the particular object's information here. Getting the point. So these are about the custom comparator, how we are trying to work here. The custom comparator, how we are trying to work with here. Right. Now we'll try to move on to the legacy classes here. So basically the legacy classes here, cutting the point, we are having some of the legacy classes here. So what are the legacy classes we are having? The first one is here, it is a array, sorry, vector. Vector is a legacy classes here. Cutting the point. So basically the legacy classes are introduced when the collection frameworks were introduced here. Cutting the point. So when this particular collection frameworks was introduced, at the time of the collection framework, the legacy classes are introduced here. So in that legacy classes, we are having the first legacy class called vector. Basically, vector is going to work like this, the particular class called ArrayList here. Right. Only we are having two differentiations here. Basically, the vector class having all the methods are synchronized here. So we already discussed in the previous example, whenever we are trying to work on the multi-threading, the synchronized concept here. Getting the point. Same way, the vector class having the methods, all are having synchronized here. Right. And so another one here, iterable. Basically, this particular vector class is not going to use the iterable, which is going to use the concept called enumeration here. Cutting the point. Enumeration here. So which is going to use the enumeration, using this particular enumeration, what we are going to do, we'll try to return the all objects here one by one. So we'll try to return the object one by one here. So to understand more here, so I want to explain the vector class here. Vector class. So you can see vector also available inside the package called java.util here. Java.util here. Now you can observe. So this particular extend class, something called abstract list. The abstract list we identified, which is extending from the array list as well as linked list and this particular vector also. Getting the point. Now you can observe. So already we identified here, because array list and vector internally both are going to work on the object array to insert the data. Cutting the point. So here the count here. Count is nothing but the size here. So you can identify capacity increment here. Right. So these are the constructors here. So what are the constructors we are having? The constructor which is expecting a initial capacity and how much we want to increment here. So at a time, how many values we want to increment here? This particular constructor is going to specify here. Another constructor we are having, initial capacity. So this is the initial capacity. By default, we are having the initial capacity called 10. same way how we are having the particular array list here, how we are having the particular array list here. So this is a collection of object which is going to pass here. But now you can observe here the method we are having here, copy into the particular method we are having the keyword called synchronized here. So only the difference here, all the method we are going to have synchronized here. So these are the vector classes are going to use whenever we are trying to check with multi-threading related applications here. Whenever we are trying to check with multi-threading related applications here, right? So you can check with all the methods here. Ensured capacity also we are having synchronized. So this is the private method, internally it's calling. So we don't want to use the synchronous, because so this method is going to call from outside of this particular another method. So the outside method definitely will have synchronized here. Getting the point. So now you can identify set size. The set size also we're having synchronized here. Getting the point. So this is we need to understand regarding this particular vector class. Whatever the methods we're having here, basically the vector is implementing from the list interface, so that what we can do, whatever the list method we are having here, all the methods we can access here. Whatever the list method we are having, all the methods we can access here. This is also very important here. So try to practice the same example using the list interface methods. Along with this particular list interface, we can work with the collection related methods also. But only the difference here, enumeration. Only the difference here, enumeration here. So instead of working list iterator and iteratable, so what we are going to do, we'll try to check with the enumeration concept here. Right. So those example, we'll try to work on the enumeration, because this is the concept is newly added in the 1.2 version. But as of now, we did not discuss the particular enumeration related information here. Okay. Now we will observe how exactly the particular enumeration will contain here. So basically the enumerations also, it's going to work same like a iterable iterator and list iterator here. So this is the one interface called enumeration, and you can observe which is having as more elements. Now we can identify, since this is coming from the 1.0, so now we can identify this particular interface having two methods, has more elements and next element. Same way, has next element and next element, how we identify the particular iterator, same way this particular enumerations also having the same. But for the legacy classes, we are going to work this particular enumeration concept here. This particular enumeration we are going to work here. So we'll try to continue the simple example on this particular vector class in tomorrow. So maybe we are going to complete this particular collection frameworks, and after this we are going to start spring related examples here. Getting the point. So in a 1-2 days we are going to start spring related example here. Right, after completion of this particular legacy classes here. Okay, any questions regarding our today's session? Any questions we are having? Okay, so if we don't have anything, we'll try to conclude this session. We'll continue tomorrow.